Hello, dear friends. Ewell Humphreys here, and I'm glad to be able to share with you again a word from the Bible, a word that I believe will bless your heart today. I hope it will. I want to speak to you on the subject that we are tested and tried. We're tested and tried. That's part of the Christian life. Tested and tried before our God. Because this is the only way that our faith can grow, is through being tried and tested. So the Lord has to put us through the test, and He has to put us in the trials. And the Bible says over in James, the first chapter, in verse 1 and 2, it says, my brethren, count it all joy when you fall into different kinds of temptations and trials, knowing this, that the trying of your faith works patience. But let patience have her perfect work, that you may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing. What we need to see here is the fact that trials and troubles and temptations that we have to face in life, these trials are working for us. And one thing they're doing is they work patience. We need patience. If you were completely patient, dear friend, you would be perfect. If you were completely patient, you would accept everything that comes without arguing. You would accept everything that happens to you and thank God. If you were patient, you would wait on the Lord to accept what He wants you to do, and you'd walk in perfection. Well, none of us are perfect. We are all impatient. I know I am. There are times when I get impatient. I want something. I'm kind of like the old woman that prayed and said, Lord, give me patience, and please, hurry up. We get in a hurry for what we need. But there's only one way in the world that you're going to learn to be patient, and that's through trials and troubles. Someone says, well, if that's the fact, I'm not going to pray for trials and troubles. Well, it would be a good thing, because you see, you'd be saying, I don't want to be patient, and that's not good. The more patient you are, the more peace you're going to have. The more patience you have, the more power you'll have with God and men. The more patience you have, the more like Jesus you're going to become. And you need patience. And this is the way we get patience, is by our trials and troubles. And so praise God. And then over is another scripture over there in James, in the 12th verse in that same chapter of James. And it says this, let the man that endureth temptation be blessed. For when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord hath promised to them that love him. Let every man, when he is tried, and whatever that trial might be, blessed is that man. Because when he endures the temptations and endures the trials, then he will receive a crown of life. Oh, he'll be rewarded in heaven. Now, I want you to know, dear friends, that we need to count it a joy when we fall into trials and troubles and say, Lord God, I'm sorry if I brought this on myself. Forgive me. But I want to thank you now that I'm in this time of trouble, because now I'm running out of self and I'm looking to you for help. And I'm going to ask for patience and wait on you until you move. Until you do, I thank you for this thing. And so we need to recognize the fact that we have to endure sometimes. Blessed is the man that endures temptation. You're in trouble now, and it doesn't seem like God has answered. God has heard your prayer. God is waiting for the best time, the right hour to move in your life. In the meantime, you endure, and God will bless you for that endurance. And then we read again over in the book of 2 Corinthians in the 12th chapter. Paul said, I prayed for the Lord to remove affliction from me, from a certain affliction that he was suffering. And he said, no, but my grace is sufficient for you. Then he says, therefore, I will rather glory in my troubles, that the power of Christ might rest upon me. So he realized that if he had to come to the place where he couldn't lift the burden, he had to say, Lord, I can't do it, but I'm looking to you. And then the power comes when you look away from yourself and you look to him. And this is important. And this is what I want you to understand and to do. Then he says, therefore, I take pleasure in my troubles because when I'm weak, then I'm strong. I take pleasure in my troubles, for when I'm weak, then I'm strong. Oh, my dear friends, if we can learn to do this, to take our problems to Jesus, and to know that when we do that, we're going to be blessed, and God will bless us for it. Well, we're in the book of 1 Peter. Let me just close with this word. First chapter of 1 Peter, verse 7 and 8, it says, wherein you greatly rejoice, though now for a season you may be under manifold and different kinds of trials. But this is so that the trial of your faith, being more precious than gold that perishes in the fire, will be found unto honor and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ. And so what the Lord is doing is purifying your faith when he puts you in the trial. And so some of you are in a trial right now. You're under a burden, and you have a tendency to complain. I want you to do something. I want you to look up and say, God, help me to be grateful for this burden. Help me to be grateful for this time of trouble. Help me to thank you for it, because you said in the Word of God, be thankful, and I will bless you, and I'll make you strong to come out, and you'll come out, and you'll be not afraid, and you'll be a stronger Christian, because you stood up for the Word of God. Oh, my dear friends, we're tested and tried, but we're coming through. In the name of the Lord Jesus, may God bless you. Amen.